roller skates, the lights, hot sky and clear blue skies, the waves are crashing by.
When she passed me by, she gave a wink and smile. I was on cloud nine.
The way you move your hips and lick your lips, the way you tip, you got me up so high. Oh, girl, you got that body with them, 'cause I could Bugatti, I just want to try.
Dan hari ini kita mau ngomongin semua lagu-lagu yang pastinya keren banget nih ya. These are songs yang benar-benar uplifting your mood.
Yes, dan juga yang di request sama kalian.
Right. Dan yang barusan kita nyanyiin adalah Hula Hoop by Omi.
Yeah, that is overplayed now. Kalau Cheerleader kemarin it was over. Now it's Hula Hoop's turn.
But it's okay, it's a nice song.
They're it is a catchy
typical,
song.
Typical, similar gitu.
I agree.
Okay, let's start off with Omi. Omi ini dia itu, he's a Jamaican singer.
Yes.
Bokapnya ternyata juga singer.
Oh, he's a musician as well.
Musician juga.
Okay, dan katanya ini he started his career when he was 9 years old and
right.
Finally got serious with his right. music career pas dia umur 14 tahun. Yeah. And he's doing great now.
He's doing great.
Look at him.
Jadi dari Cheerleader, phenomenon hit, and yeah. now sekarang ada Hula Hoop yang also a phenomenon.
Yeah. Dan yang paling keren ini ya, lirik-lirik yang dia pakai itu judul-judul lagunya dia, it's always so catchy.
Right.
Jadi kamu juga gak mungkin bisa lupa gitu, Cheerleader, right. Hula Hoop, what's next?
And you know what, kayak Omi ini for me is like the Meghan Trainor male version. Typical musiknya itu seperti itu, it's just one of those music that just gets in your head.
Mungkin karena kayak saking ikoniknya aja kali ya, lagu-lagu right. dan juga music production-nya Omi gitu.
Yes. Tapi sebelum dia jadi penyanyi, if you guys didn't know, dia tuh sebenarnya dia tuh rapper and also a breakdancer.
Cool, right? Wow.
Tapi anyway, langsung aja kita kasih video clip. Ini dia Cheerleader, tapi versi Pentatonix ya. This
okay.
is cool. Alright, nah kita udah ngomongin dari luar ya. Sekarang yang dari Indo apa ya yang lagi sering di cover banget ya?
Yang lagi sering banget di cover tuh menurut aku tuh berada di pelukanmu, mengajarkanku. Gila ya, Bian. Waktu itu kamu udah ketemu sama dia ya?
Dulu waktu itu lagunya belum booming. Dia waktu itu di breakout, sempet di breakout, nyanyiin lagunya. Oh, like, dang, ini lagu lucu banget. Suara dia bagus banget. Tiba-tiba,
boom.
Everywhere.
Yes.
Dan sekarang menjadi nomor 1 di iTunes charts. Congratulations, Rizky.
Yeah. Dan susah banget katanya untuk digeser lagu Kesempurnaan Cinta
right.
itu. Benar-benar all the other singles that are coming out cannot move Kesempurnaan
so
Cinta.
Tight.
Karena
Down
emang
banget.
Menurut aku tuh he kinda like replaced Tulus for a bit. Kan Tulus kan rada ngilang bentar nih kan.
Right.
Vakum habis itu he came out.
Gantian.
And then like man, he killed it.
Nice song like this.
Okay, welcome back guys. Now we're gonna talk about a really cool band from the UK.
Yes, Coldplay. Dan ternyata yang ngefans sama Coldplay bukan kita-kita doang, rakyat jelata, tetapi President Barack Obama.
Yeah.
Yang suka sama Coldplay. Dan Obama tau gak taruh speech-nya itu di dalam musiknya Coldplay?
Really?
Yes, ada dari salah satu lagu di albumnya Coldplay, ada speech dari Obama di tengah-tengah lagunya Coldplay itu.
Oh, mungkin karena dari Coldplay-nya juga minta izin kali ya sama
pasti.
Obama kayak.
Tapi karena Obama ngefans langsung diizinin tanpa harus kontrak or whatever.
Wow, that is sick. Very cool. Alright, menurut aku ya, one of Coldplay's really cool songs is like Viva La Vida ya.
Itu ada dua versi.
Really?
Kamu udah pernah lihat video klipnya belum? So they have two different versions of the video clip.
Nah,
itu dua versinya tuh beda-beda. Jadi orang tuh boleh pilih yang mana antara salah satu atau salah. You guys check it out.
Wah, you should. Karena mereka ini emang keren banget. You know how many awards they've gotten? Hundreds.
A lot, man.
Yeah.
Kalau aku nih ya, Coldplay paling suka Yellow. Udah itu fix. Yellow is the best Coldplay song. And then after that, Him for the Weekend.
Ah, I agree with you. Okay, guys. Other than Coldplay nih ya, kita juga ada salah satu band. Mereka ini tuh trio bersaudara. Namanya Before You Exit.
Yes, that's right. Before You Exit ini. Dan mereka pernah jadi openingnya buat Fifth Harmony. Pernah jadi, you know, they're like, they traveling a lot. Jadi mereka, they're doing really good. Tapi, mungkin di seluruh dunia belum begitu booming, tapi dia tuh booming banget di Filipina, di Singapura, pokoknya di Malaysia, negara-negara Asia banyak banget fansnya di sana.
Ya, sekarang mereka ini juga sering banget nih nge-cover guys, dari One Direction sampai lagu-lagu Justin Bieber juga mereka suka nge-cover. So they're really talented guys. Alright, I wanna show them actually a little snippet of Before You Exit.
Okay.
Check it out.
Yes, dan itu dia Gama Audio Cantika, keren banget ya. They got to meet with Kurt Schneider.
Oh my god, keren banget keren sih. Aku waktu itu juga nonton tuh yang sama Kurt sama The Overtones, bagus juga tuh.
Oh, they covered also.
Yeah, The Overtones is also a trio, by the way.
Oh wow, that's
cool. You should search for it in that's YouTube. Cool.
Okay, next up nih ya, kita ada Isyana Saraswati yang aku baru tahu dia tuh dulu tinggalnya di Belgia.
Wow.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, jadi dari kecil nih katanya guys, dia udah tinggal di Belgia, dan when she reached like SMP atau SD, correct me if I'm wrong, dia ini baru pindah ke Indonesia.
Indonesia, that's right. Dia lulusan dari Nanyang.
Oh,
Nanyang,
yes.
Nanyang, Singapore.
Yeah, that was when she went into uni.
Yeah.
Pokoknya her studies is like so broad.
Right.
Keluar negeri terus orangnya. Keren banget, tapi she's very smart.
She's very smart, she's very great. Langsung aja kita play Isyana Saraswati.
Dan hari ini aku bakal ngajarin kamu cara main lagu One Call Away. Oke, ini semuanya is really simple karena kita mainnya benar-benar bolak-balik dari C, A minor, F, G, and I'm sure you guys know how to play that. It's really simple chords. Dan tadi aku sebenarnya mainnya dengan kapuk buat cewek-cewek yang mungkin range vokalnya kan nggak sama kayak Charlie Puth karena itu suara cowok gitu. Jadi you can use a capo so it can be a little higher for you. That's why I used a capo and I played it from C. But the real key of One Call Away ini tuh sebenarnya dari C chord over here. But we are going to play it from C, so it's so much simpler. Okay? Very simple. Dari awalnya, dari verse, you use the simple chords dari C. Lalu ke G. A minor, ke F, ke G, kembali lagi ke C. Alright guys, dan sepanjang awal lagunya ini benar-benar perpindahan chordnya tuh dari seperti itu aja, C, G, A minor, F, G, ke C lagi. Buat I'm only one call away. I'll be there to save the day. One call away. I'll be there to save the day. Superman's got nothing on me. I'm only one call away. Very simple. And when you get to the verse, we're gonna start with an A minor to G. C and to F.
Call me baby if you need a friend. I just wanna give you love. so take a chance. And di bagian pre-chorus ya, no matter where you go, you know you're not alone. Itu dari F. No matter where you go, ke G. No, you're not alone. And you go back to that chorus that we played in the beginning of the song. Yang dari C, G, A minor, F, G, C lagi. Alright, best of luck everyone. It's really simple. Buat kalian yang mau lihat aku mainin fullnya, langsung aja di sini nih, di YouTube link ini. Okay, good luck. Bye.
Hi,
alright guys. Tadi aku baru ajarin cara main One Call Away. I hope that helped.
Charlie Puth song itu lagi di mana-mana juga ya.
Itu lagi catchy crazy banget. Apalagi semenjak Charlie Puth keluarin dengan lagu See You Again with Wiz Khalifa, guys. His name kind of flew everywhere. Terus One Call Away jadi booming banget sekarang. It's everywhere. iTunes juga langsung masuk charts dan menjadi top 10 di Billboard.
Yes, See You Again juga ya. Kalau See You Again number 1 untuk berapa lama lah.
Yeah.
Anyway, ada juga nih yang lagi happening juga. Ada Jess Glynn.
Dan Jess Glynn over here, she is also very talented. Kamu tahu gak, dia ini tuh punya hobi yang unik banget.
Well, what does she do?
She likes to ride horses.
Okay.
Dia suka berkuda, guys. Okay. Seru banget.
Tapi I can see
kamu, that. Kamu udah pernah ketemu kan sama Jess Glynn?
Like, dia tuh emang tipe-tipe kayak country girl gitu. Dia
country girl?
I don't know, like the way she is, hi, hello, how are you? Kayak itu tipikal-tipikal kayak country girl, bukan yang cewek-cewek anak kota gitu. Ini anak perdesaan sana lah, kesannya
Tapi she looks really humble ya.
She's really nice.
Yes, dan musical talentsnya dan suaranya itu, man, she has a black voice,
that's
don't you think?
I really like it. Kuat langsung aja banget. Kita play, this is Jess Glynn. And after this, kita mau cover salah satu lagu yang di request sama kalian semuanya, okay?
Check. Okay, man, I love the duet. Mereka ini bagus banget. Dan Camila, her voice-nya
jago.
Heran deh. Udah pernah nonton yang acoustic live-nya mereka belum? Di radio?
Udah.
Itu Fifth Harmony. They are flawless.
I love Fifth Harmony.
Okay? My gosh.
Banyak, Dina aku suka suaranya. Camila, menurut aku jago banget. Tapi, she improvises every single time she sings.
I love it. Dan
I love it too.
Lagu I Know What You Did Last Summer ini menjadi salah satu acoustic pop track yang menjadi favorite banget saat ini.
Gitu. True that, true
I hear it everywhere on the radio.
Itu enak banget sih lagu ya.
Enak ya? Dan itu kayak gitarnya Shawn Mendes kan kuat banget ya di situ. Jadi I love it. I love it a lot.
Tapi anyways, thank you kalau kalian suka covernya. Kalau kalian gak suka juga gak apa-apa. But anyway, next up, kita ada satu lagu yang kita mau bahas nih sebelum we're gonna close the show. Justin, Skrillex and Diplo. Okay, jadi mereka ini ternyata menang di Grammys.
Wow!
Yes!
With Justin Bieber! Yes, dan ini katanya pertama kali loh mereka mendapatkan Grammy.
Aha. pertama kali mendapatkan Grammy and they deserve it.
They deserve it. Karena emang Skrillex and Diplo mereka udah senior banget juga ya, Boy, ya.
Yes, that is right.
Dan bisa membawa Justin Bieber bawa Grammy juga.
Did you watch the
time?
Kalian nonton Grammys gak pas dia ini lagi apa sih lagi perform? Mm-hmm. Kan Justin duluan kan lagu self sendiri. Uh-huh. Tapi chordsnya bukan chords asli ya.
Yeah, jadi chordsnya itu kayak pakai interval gitu, Boy. Jadi kayak dibeda-bedain. Kok interval sih? Apa ya namanya?
Ya, yeah, I don't know, like
inversion, sorry.
Ya, versi beda lah, versi beda. Terus when they met Skrillex and Diplo langsung pecah satu ruangan. Tapi anyway, lagunya ini gara-gara lagu ini mereka mendapatkan best dance recording for the Grammys. Yes. Anyway, we have to close the show. Kita ada lagu Justin Bieber, ya. Where are you now that I need you? For you after this, I'm Boy William.
Cheryl Shinafia.
Follow our Twitter di mana?
Cheryl Shinafia.
Boy William Instagram.
Cheryl Shinafia.
Boy William 17. I'll see you next time. Bye.